Hello, this is Bern, and if you have your eyes set on a guy, but he's not pursuing you, on today's video, I'm going to share with you how you can emerge from this situation with more confidence and worth and get ultimately what you're looking for. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to another edition of BernMendez.com, a space where I share with ambitious, conscious and heart-centered women how you can attract the man you want and step into the relationship you crave without the need for gimmicks, manipulation, or crazy / ziggly techniques. Now, many women who reach out to me reach out stating, I want a specific guy to be into me, whether it's their ex or whether it's a guy they just met. But typically it's a guy, a new guy into their lives, and they want that guy to pursue them, and they have no idea why the guy's not pursuing them, and they feel torn and almost slightly addicted to this need for this guy to step into and pursue them. Now, if that's ever happened to you, or if you're going through that right now, I'm gonna share with you a principle that can really make a difference, and that's the hidden blessing of rejection. I'm not sure what your spiritual beliefs are, but if they're anything like mine, you might believe that there's something out there beyond yourself that has a high purpose for you and who knows what might be best than you at times. So sometimes you're trying really hard for something to work and there's a good reason that you can't see from your limited perspective as to why it's not happening. But only when you let go and cut the umbilical cord can you then see what was in store for you. Had you stepped into this earlier thing, it wouldn't have manifested, and it's something that was far more connected to your worth and to your integrity and to your awesomeness. So right now, if this is happening to you, I want you to at least consider the possibility that a higher power is looking out for your best interest and that this thing is not meant to happen for a good reason. Number two, I want you to evaluate how much of this need that you have for this guy to pursue you and step into when you see a relationship with him in the future is based on reality, meaning how much you know him and the depth of your friendship and the connection you have with his true values versus a projection of what you think this guy is based on the feelings that you have about him. And they're not the same thing, right? Many times you want a guy to pursue you because you're telling yourself stories and lies about what this guy is, not knowing that they're stories and lies. Like, he's the most amazing guy I ever met. He shares all my values. He's like, all things that are not true, but they sound great when you say them, and you almost want to believe that they're true. So again, take a step back and recognize that the majority of what you might be feeling about this man has nothing to do with who he is, but has a lot to do with what you've placed in your mind that he is. The second area of evaluation to really know if a guy who's not pursuing you is better off not pursuing you is the bulk of your wanting this pursuit based on chemistry or based on character? Again, two different set of values. Chemistry is warm, fuzzy feelings you feel all around your body, including your heart. Character means this guy has solid virtues that he steps into that make you understand that this guy is awesome. And not just based on what he's telling you, the stories he's sharing, but based on you seeing him interact with other human beings and show up with integrity, with confidence, with a sense of growth, a sense of contribution. Who is this guy, right? Next quality to evaluate if you should really want this guy to pursue you or not is this guy a confident guy and that's part of what you like, or is this guy an arrogant guy and you're a little bit hung up on his arrogance thinking that he is actually confident? Because a confident guy has no need to be a dick towards other human beings. An arrogant guy does because he's covering up for insecurity, right? So confidence, cool. Arrogance, not cool. Is he entitled? Is he kind or unkind? Is he empathetic or is he a sociopath that doesn't care and feel what other people are going through? And again, when you evaluate this guy that you seem so keen on connecting with, just I want you to know, understand if he's really confident or if he's an arrogant guy. Next quality to evaluate is this need for his pursuit based on fun or based on depth? Again, not saying that fun can be deep, but primarily, is this something that you're connecting with because you're having a fun time with him and he's a cool guy to hang out with in the short term? Or is this a sustainable, long-term, deep holding of space and ability to connect and want to really get to know you that's causing this need for you to crave his pursuit? Next category, is this something that you're feeling excited about but has no sustainability, or is it something sustainable? And excitement means that, I mean, again, you see the guy, you create this idea about him, and you feel those warm feelings, but sustainable means that the guy is interested in pursuing you, has a clear idea about what he wants, and what he wants aligns with what you want, right? That's sustainable. As I shared in my previous video, a guy who is incredible but doesn't want to pursue you is worthless to you. And you can spend your days trying to figure out a way to get him to look at you, or you can rise, shine, move on, and connect with many other men who will see your value, your worth, your beauty, your passion, your intelligence, your awesomeness, and will want to, on their own, connect with you without you having to twist their arm. And that's my recommendation. If you're caught right now up in a situation where you feel like the guy is not pursuing you and you're craving that, stop telling yourself the story that he's an awesome guy. He's not an awesome guy towards you. And there's many other guys in this boundless universe, in this amazing, abundant earth, who can connect to what you're looking for and give that and offer it to you if you're open to them. Raise your standards by choosing men who choose you. Hope this is helpful, useful, and insightful. If it is, and you want to enter a passionate relationship that has sustainable ground to grow on, then on the first link on the description of this video, I created a training to show you how to do that. All you have to do is click on the first link, enter your name and email, and you'll be immediately taken to this free training. If you like this video, click like or thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. If you click the little bell when you subscribe, you'll be notified of new episodes as they come out. Last but not least, you've been watching videos, reading books, you name it. And this reality of entering a passionate yet fulfilling relationship is not showing up for you, you might significantly benefit from personalized help. And if you're interested in figuring out if I can help you, second link in the description will allow you to apply to connect with me. We're a fit, I'll share with you how this works, and I might be able to hold your hand through this process so you can get there in a fraction of the time. Thank you so much for connecting with me, and as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.